Well, Coulson, have you learnt your lesson? Or isn't 4 days long enough?
Yes, Miss Bennet.
Well, you've come down a peg or two. Now, come on, back to the laundry.
Miss Bennet, what about B. Smith?
What about her?
I told the governor on her.
It so happens we're aware of your little feud with Smith. We'll be keeping an eye on things. And the governor has decided to give you a new cellmate.
Who?
Come on.
Please.
Kathleen Leach, seeing you ask so nicely. But you should be very grateful, Coulson, that we didn't leave you to spend tonight with Smith before the changeover. Come on.
Can I say goodbye to Janet through the door?
You certainly can't. Now, come on.
Bye, Janet.
I'm warning you. Just be careful or you'll end up back in the pound.
Come on, love, buck up. It's the waiting, Bee. You've got to learn to put all that behind you. You've got to think about your own trial and your other kids.
Well, that's what everyone keeps telling me.
Well, maybe because it's right. Well, don't you love your other kids?
Well, of course I do. But how do you expect me to stop loving David?
Well, I'll do that for you.
Oh, it's all right, Kev. I'm okay.
What are you lot standing around for? Get back to work.
Oh, sorry, Vera, but no one told us you was coming. Hello, Roz.
How are you?
Leach, you and Coulson will be sharing a cell together. Coulson, you help Leach fold those sheets.
Good to see you, Roz.
Any trouble from you, Smith, and you're in for it.
I don't know what you're talking about, Miss Bennet.
Hey, that terrace woman was in solitary. Did you get to talk to her?
I got to know her quite well.
Did she really murder that bloke in America?
Of course she did. Except that it wasn't murder. It was an act of war.
An act of war?
Well, it was.
Ah, come off it, love. Listen, when I killed my old man, that was an act of war too. But it was also murder. And I didn't make any fancy excuses.
She basically wants the same things we do. A better deal for the working people. Which is fighting the capitalist system. Oh, you wouldn't understand.
Right, I want two people for cleaning duty. You, Kath, and you, Pauline.
Can I work with Kath, Mrs. Jackson?
You're volunteering to scrub floors.
Well, I'd rather not work in the laundry.
Well, I'm sure Pauline won't mind. Well, move along.
That kid just loves trouble.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
Bought you some flowers.
Thank you.
How are you?
Well, I think I'm improving. I'm starting to feel uncomfortable.
That's a good sign. You've got a long way to go yet.
Look, I'm flying back to Queensland this afternoon, but I'm going to speak to Charles, and I want you and Greg to join us as soon as you're out of hospital.
Oh, that'd be nice.
Well, I'll go and find Sister and get her to put these in water.
Thanks, ma'am.
Do you know how good it is to see you looking so much better?
I've been waiting to see you all morning.
No more problems now, I promise. We're going to lead quiet, reputable lives.
Greg,
mm-hmm.
Can I ask you something? I'm going to be scarred, aren't I? All down my side and on my face.
Karen, my darling, that's the least of our worries. I'm just grateful to have you. Besides, that can be taken care of with skin grafts.
Really?
Yes.
I hope you don't think I'm being vain or stupid. I guess, under the circumstances, I'm just lucky to be alive.
It's a perfectly normal reaction.
Thanks. Greg?
Mm-hmm.
I love you.
I love you, too. Hey, got some news for you. Put the practice on the market this morning.
Already?
Don't get excited. It's not the most salubrious practice, and we may have to wait a while. But I'll give Erica my notice. And by the time you're out of here, we'll be able to go to Queensland together.
Well, I better tell Angela pretty soon.
Well, you'll have no problem there. The halfway house, I'm amazed to say, is carrying on quite happily without you.
She's a really terrific person. Bea and Pat could never understand her, though. They're too old.
Yeah.
You never change people like them. I wish you could meet her. I think you'd like her.
Well, one thing's for sure. I'm not going to go to the pound just to find out.
Oh, don't worry. She won't be in there for too much longer.
How come? Is she going to escape?
She didn't say.
Oh, come on, Roz, I won't tell nobody.
You got a visitor, Coulson? Someone called Sandra Thompson.
From school? Oh, great.
Yeah, well, that trip may be a bucket, eh?
Sandra!
Hi, Roz.
Oh, it's great to see you. Sit down. What did you do to your arm?
Oh, it's my hand, actually. Oh, it's nothing serious. One of my boyfriends had an accident in his car.
Oh,
it's just inconvenient. It means I can't write.
Uh-huh. You're always writing at school, aren't you? Essays and stuff.
Oh, still do a bit. Well, I don't get much too time for it these days, though.
Mm.
We had time for everything then.
Didn't we ever?
Do you remember that time we put that laxative in the urn? In the staff common room?
Oh, yeah, sure I do.
And the place was deserted for days. Oh, and do you remember Miss Devine, our Spanish teacher?
Uh-huh.
I ran into her the other day, and she wanted to know how you were.
Oh.
And when I told her, she'd ask if you'd write to her.
Oh, I will.
Oh, would you need her address?
Yes, I'm afraid I do. She moved, didn't she?
Mm, that's right. Excuse me, I can't write. My hand? Can I give Roz a pen and paper so she can take down the address?
Yes, of course.
Q?
14 Jones Street, Kensington. I can't remember the postcode.
Oh, that's okay. I can look that up. Thanks.
How are you finding it in here anyway?
Oh, it takes a bit of getting used to.
Do you remember our dorm at school? When you always used to sleep under the window. Do they let you have a window in yourself?
Of course they do. It's primitive, but it's not that bad.
Do you have a good view?
Oh, fine. Except when the sun comes up in the morning, it shines in. Wakes me up.
Oh, it's a bit hard to take.
Mm.
You always were a night owl. Well, I better be going. Oh, and don't forget to write to Miss Devine. She'd really love to hear from you.
Well, it's great to see you.
Thanks very much.
Thought you must have come back here. What's that?
Oh, it's nothing. It's just some bits and pieces Sandra left for me.
I know what it is. She's a friend of Janet's, isn't she? And this is all part of your escape
plan. Shut up, will you?
Oh, come on, Roz. You know I can keep my mouth shut.
Right. I'm going to escape with Janet. Her friends are tough, Kathleen. If you let on anything about this, they'll send someone here to kill you, just like they killed that man in New York.
You can trust me, Roz. But how the hell are you going to do it?
Well, day after I get the signal, I have to drop these capsules into the officer's coffee urn by 3 p.m. The time release capsules. How's that for organization? They can make the screws go to sleep whenever they want them to.
What's the signal?
Note says I have to watch for flashing headlights every night.
Gee, Roz.
She wanted to know which side of the prison my window was on. I let her know it was on the east side, right under Fletcher's nose.
Roz, are you sure you should be with this mob? I mean, bombs and stuff.
They can do anything they want. Everybody's scared of them. Besides, anything's better than being locked up in here.
Good morning, Kathleen.
Good, I be.
Just a sec, Roz. What do you want to go getting yourself transferred out the laundry for?
I just wanted to, that's all.
Look, I'm just trying to help.
Well, I don't need your help.
Well, suit yourself. You told Vera yesterday that I'd been threatening you, right? Oh, now, come on, love. I don't have to be mandraked to work that one out. What's got into you?
Oh, just leave me alone.
Wake up to yourself, Roz.
Smith? You're warned, Smith.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Intimidating Coulson.
She was not, Miss Bennet.
Just stay out of this, Leech. Well, it looks as if I arrived just in time, Coulson.
We were just...